Some hard work in the hot sun building that today. But how hot did it get? The actual air temperature, believe it or not, below the average, just a little bit. We'd normally be at 95 degrees for this time of year. Came in just under that at 94 degrees, and it was actually a little bit cooler of a morning too, coming in at 74. We'd typically be around 76, and we have been the past couple of days. No rain, but hey, we don't quite need it. We're above for the year. But one thing that helped with some of that heat today, you've heard me talk about it already, was the sea breeze. Well, I can show you that on our sky cam that overlooks the marina here in downtown Corpus Christi. So right around 11 a.m., we had a sky full of a few fair weather cumulus clouds, but watch as these begin to move out. We see that direction change east inland, and no clouds to be seen here if you're looking over the water. That is the sea breeze. It kicks those clouds out, sends them inland, and that breeze actually helps to make things feel a little bit cooler. So we can see that now on the feels like temperatures. It feels like 98 in Port Aransas, feels like 103 at the Naval Air Station there in Flower Bluff. But take a trip just a couple miles inland and it is oppressively hot. 111 is the feels like in Beeville, 104 in Orange Grove, and it feels like 102 degrees in San Diego at this time. So the actual air temperatures, yeah, they're coming down, but it's still a hot one out there. 89 now in Ingleside, 89 in Rockport, 87 in Port Aransas. Again, cooler because of that sea breeze, but it's still 93 in Mathis, Orange Grove, and Alice. So a couple more hours and we'll finally get down to a little more of a comfortable temperature. Should be a good night to have dinner outside if you can fight the mosquitoes out there. No rain here on Doppler radar. Things quiet, but we're going to see some of that returning to the forecast here as we head into the middle part of the week. It's all because of this weather pattern that's been pretty constant here over the past couple of days with high pressure over the Gulf of Mexico. But we're going to start seeing some of that tropical moisture moving back in. So with the heat, that'll cook up a few scattered showers here and there across our area. Now, we've had some hazy sunsets on account of that Saharan dust. Another plume is going to be making its way into the Gulf of Mexico, so we'll keep that in the forecast for the weekend. But it's been keeping the tropics pretty quiet, all except for one area of interest at the National Hurricane Center. Now thinks has a pretty low chance of development. This area of interest is going to be moving inland across parts of northern Florida, southern Georgia, so not really much of an opportunity for it to do anything. That's good news there. Things otherwise quiet across the tropics. Here locally, we're looking at some rain to move in over the week. It looks like maybe accumulations up to a half inch, and the Victoria Crossroads could get to an inch, but generally going to stay pretty dry here, and we'll see the bulk of the rain coming in generally on Wednesday. Not much else going on. It's going to clear out by the weekend and look pretty good. So the 7-day forecast, yeah, other than being hot, it looks nice. We'll have those scattered showers in the forecast Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and then the hazy, humid heat returns for next weekend. Got you.